Hey guys, Dr. Huntington here. Let's talk about one of the most toxic items that you probably have in your house. In fact, you probably cook with it. It's aluminum. In this video, we're going to cover why you need to reduce your exposure to it and how to replace your aluminum products. First, aluminum is a neurotoxin, meaning that it harms your central nervous system. There's no dispute over this fact. It's cold hard science. And repeated exposure causes aluminum to build up in your blood, your muscles, and your organs, including your brain. Even exposure to minute amounts over time can add up to big problems because it affects your brain and neuromusculoskeletal system. In fact, it is closely linked to Alzheimer's disease, epilepsy, ADHD, chronic fatigue, and bone disease. And in case you're new to this health thing, you don't want any of those. Okay, so where is aluminum found in your home? Well, the most obvious is aluminum pots and pans and utensils. These are dangerous because the metal leaches into your food during the cooking process. This leaching happens particularly with acidic foods. When these acidic foods come into contact with the aluminum, it literally causes the leaching to occur. Worse yet, aluminum is also a food additive. What? Yeah, it's being put into your food. It's often in pickles and processed cheese and baking powders and mixes. Other products that contain aluminum include antacids, deodorant, vaccinations and baby formula, cosmetics, dyes, and cans. And the ever popular and almost universally present in every kitchen, aluminum foil. Unfortunately, if you are like most people, you touch aluminum daily through one or more of these items. So what you need to do from this point moving forward is to reduce your exposure. Replace aluminum cookware with glass, stone, ceramic, or silicone. Use glass Tupperware or reusable non-toxic plastic bags for storage. And use only wood or plastic cooking utensils, especially when the cookware that you're using you're unsure about. This minimizes the scratching of the cookware surface and can reduce the leach into your food. Use glass lids on baking dishes and stainless steel grill baskets instead of aluminum foil. Check all food labels, especially spices. You may see the word aluminum in conjunction with other words like aluminum phosphate or aluminum oxide or just alum. These are all harmful ingredients that you want to avoid. Also, check your deodorant label and see if it contains aluminum salts. If so, get rid of it. But don't forget to replace it with deodorant that does not contain aluminum. Over-the-counter medications can also contain aluminum, so always look for aluminum-free options. Advocate for aluminum-free vaccines. There's a big debate in this country over many aspects of vaccine programs, and I'm not going to get into that here in this video. But there's nobody that can competently argue that injecting aluminum is a good idea, even in small amounts. One way to handle aluminum exposure is to consume silica, because it can help remove aluminum from your body. Silica, or silicone dioxide, is a hard, unreactive compound which occurs in like quartz, sandstone, and other rocks. Silica actually binds with aluminum molecules and pulls them out of your body. Silica also has anti-aging properties and works with calcium to maintain bone strength. Healthy food sources of silica include cucumbers, bell peppers, and tomatoes. And you can also get silica in capsule form as a supplement. In fact, my supplement line, when a specific combination of ingredients causes manufacturing difficulty and we have to add a material to help with the manufacturing process, we often choose silica. And we use it specifically because it has, you know, these healthy properties. And it's way better than a lot of the suspect fillers that some companies actually put in their supplements. If you'd like to see my product line, just go to BodyManual.com. Lastly, let's look at some ways that you can detoxify your body from aluminum and other heavy metals. First, get regular exercise. Second, make sure that you supplement with vitamin C. Use cold-pressed, unrefined organic coconut oil. Drink plenty of purified water and include garlic and parsley in your diet as much as possible. And tonight, take a look in your kitchen and at your deodorant label and make the changes where necessary. Okay, I'll see you in the next video.